welcome to the inaugural Blue Marble GeoTalks online geoconference. My name is David McKittrick, and I will be your host throughout the day. We're delighted and overwhelmed by the level of interest in this conference. Registrations exceeded our expectations. We're so glad that you were able to take time out of your day to learn a little bit about what we're doing, not only from folks on the Blue Marble staff, but also from some of our users. Over the next 6 hours, we're going to be hearing from a number of industry experts, lending their expertise in a variety of fields, from uncovering Mayan ruins in Mexico to introducing the new coordinate systems that are coming in just a couple of years for those of us here in North America. Before I hand over to our president, Patrick Cunningham, for some opening remarks, let me first cover a few housekeeping issues. This is a webinar. Some of you who have attended our webinars before will be familiar with this setup. Communication is one way. You will hear from us, but unfortunately, we cannot hear you. So if you have questions, and we expect you to have questions for our presenters, please use the questions panel on the right side of your screen in the GoToMeeting sidebar. You can type questions anytime during the presentation. At the close of each presentation, we will read some of those questions, time permitting. Given the numbers that have registered, I anticipate that we will not get through all of those questions. And if necessary, we will send the questions to the presenter and they can follow up with you directly. As far as our agenda is concerned, again, we have a full day. We're going to begin with Patrick telling us a little bit about what's going on here at Blue Marble. Our first speaker is Anthony Beach from BSP Engineers, going to be providing some examples of the use of US technology using Global Mapper, including the LiDAR module. We'll have a break between our sessions. Going to be hearing from Katrina Schweikert, one of my colleagues. You may have heard her presenting in some of our webinars. She's going to be giving some tips and tricks on the use of our software. We'll then hand over to Michael Frings, joining us today from Germany. Michael is a longtime user of our software, and he's going to be showing us an example of the use of some of the 3D technology, and specifically for a case study for positioning advertising poles, something that we don't consider when we're thinking of terrain analysis, but the visibility of advertising poles and how topography can affect those. We're going to take a break for lunch right around 9:45 here on the east coast of the US. We're going to take about an hour, just over an hour break, and we'll come back about 1. And we will present the winner of our academic scholarship. We introduced this academic scholarship late last year, and we've selected our winner. We're going to hopefully be connecting with our winner and making that presentation. And we'll also have an opportunity, time permitting, to conduct a little geo challenge, a little quiz, if you like. And there's a copy of Global Mapper on the line for the winner of that geo challenge. Our first speaker of the afternoon session is Dan Martin. We're delighted that Dan was able to join us from the NGS, talking about the new coordinates coming in 2022. For those of us here in North America, this is a very important milestone, so it's really important that we're aware of this change that is happening. We will bring Kat back on again to do some additional tips and tricks halfway through our afternoon session. And to wrap up, our final speaker, we're really delighted that Daniel Fagerman could join us today from LiDAR USA. Daniel's company has featured on some of the TV channels recently about the work they're doing in Mexico and Central America using LiDAR technology to uncover ancient ruins. So Daniel is going to be sharing some of those experiences with us and talking about the process of using that technology in an archaeological context. These presentations will be recorded. They will be made available exclusively to you who register. Hopefully sometime next week we can have those packaged up. You will get an email from us indicating that they are available. Throughout today, and we hope you can stay for as many of these sessions as possible, but throughout today, we expect people will have to leave and come back when necessary, and that is perfectly fine. The URL that you were assigned is unique to you, and you can log in when you're available. We encourage you to, when available, to spend time and listen to our presentations. I do request that if you do have to leave, that you log out of the system so it frees up one of the slots for someone else. We do have a finite number of people who can log in concurrently, so if you're not available for one of the sessions, please log out. You can, as I said, log in for the presentations that you're interested in.